Yesterday we have started a chapter, standardization, where we have seen the definition of the stability and how the product or that drug material is acceptable if all the phenomena it is proper, such as physical, chemical, microbiological, therapeutics and toxicological specifications. Then we have seen what is the stability and what five types of stability or which points should be included in the stability. So we have seen physical, we have seen chemical, in the physical appearance, color, then the solubility, palatability, uniformity that we have seen. And in the chemical, we have seen the chemical integrity should be maintained. If it is a potency, then it should be properly maintained, it should be properly labeled, and it should be uninfluenced by the external factors. Today we will take the microbiological factor. So the stability or resistance to microbial group or the microbial growth is retained according to the specified requirements. So the group of bacteria should not be grow there, or the growth of the bacteria should be restricted there. That is the main aim of this microbiological factor. And hence, we have to add certain antimicrobial agent which can retain the effectiveness of that drug substance, or which can retain the effectiveness of that mother tincture. So to restrict the growth of bacteria, for that we have to keep or we have to store or we have to purchase that drug substance properly. There should not be any intervention of the viruses or any bacteria or any pathogen. Then the therapeutic effect remains unchanged. There should not be any break in the chemical integrity. And the last one is toxicological. No significant increase in toxicity. If it is a venom, that venom is having that much toxicity, it should be remain as it is. It should not increase beyond that, and it should not be a decrease. The power should not decrease of that venom. So these are the five factors or the five important types of stability: physical, chemical, microbiological, therapeutic and toxicologic. Then what is the aim of this stability? So why we are maintaining all these things? What is our aim in this? So the aim is, the ultimate aim of standardization is to produce homeopathic drugs that are highly efficacious in. So yesterday only we have discussed if the product is having a certain standard, that means it is having a quality, it is having a purity, and this will reflect in the efficacy. So the quality should be proper, and the safety is also important. Safety in the sense when you are storing it, if it is not using immediately, or if it is using immediately, then it should be stored properly when the product will fall. So in any case, or in the both the cases, the quality and the safety is important. So our aim of standardization is to produce the highly efficacious drug so that the quality is maintained. We will get the proper result. We will get the proving properly. So all the things will be proper if it is the efficacy will be a good one, if you are maintaining the quality and if you are maintaining the safety of it. So this is the aim of stability. Then the different methods of drugs standardization, by which way we are standardizing our drug substances. Jaise humne kal dekha tha ki if you are purchasing something, we are taking some points in your mind. If I want to purchase one cloth or one shirt or t-shirt, then that should be of color. You will see the texture of that cloth. You will see the length of that cloth, the size of that cloth. So you are taking into the consideration, or you are having the certain points in your mind before you are purchasing that cloth. Or it may be the food, it may be the cosmetic, it may be the simple handkerchief. So these are the certain points that you should keep in your mind before you are purchasing. So these are the 5 points on the basis of which we are doing the standardization. अगर ये पांचों पॉइंट क्लियर है, देन ओनली वी विल परचेज दैट ड्रग सब्सटेंस और दैट क्रूड ड्रग सब्सटेंस, और वी आर परचेसिंग द पोटेंसी फ्रॉम दैट मैन्युफैक्चरिंग यूनिट आल्सो. सो फर्स्ट मेथड इज द ऑर्गेनोलेप्टिक. सो ऑर्गेनो मीन्स आवर ऑर्गन्स. सो जो 5 सेंसेस है अपने, विद द हेल्प ऑफ दैट वी आर डूइंग द इवैल्यूएशन. सो दैट इज नोन एज ऑर्गेनोलेप्टिक. Second one is the microscopic evaluation. So we are observing that powder or that roots or that stem or the leaves or any animal product by using the microscope. Then we are identifying their types of tissues which are present. Third one is the physical evaluation, then the chemical evaluation and the biological evaluation. So one by one we will take all these 5 methods of drug standardization. In the chemical, we are doing the chemical analysis so that the purification or the characteristic of that particular cell or that particular drug can be identified. In the physical, we are doing the certain laboratory methods to identify or to get the purity of that drug substance. So the standardization of vehicles we are doing in the same manner, standardization of mother tincture we are doing, standardization of different vehicles just like oil, spermaceti or the starch also we are doing. And there are the certain centers in our India where the standardization process is carried out. So first we will take the organoleptic. So in the organoleptic evaluation, the organs of senses such as eyes or the so we are using here nose, tongue to test, nose for odor, skin for the touch. It includes microscopic appearance, its odor, its taste and feel of drug to touch. Occasionally the group of the fracture of the plant material is also considered. So size and the shape, for example, the underground plant part includes the rhizomes, roots, then bulbs, tubers. So their entire slice should be available. So if it is broken, then it is a cut or it is a broken into the pieces, then we have to check its standardization again by the different method, or we have to note it. Okay, this is the break or some fracture is there, or it is broken into the pieces. Then there are the different shapes of that particular pieces available. For example, it is cylindrical in case of Serra Saperilla. Then it is a conical in case of aconite. So they are the different sizes of their length and the breadth are available. The diameter may changes. So this we have to check properly. Second one is the external color. So the color may be vary from the yellowish or yellow or the gray yellow, or it may be the brown of that root ka color, stem ka color, yeah, bark ka color, it may differ. Then external marking also we have to note down, whether the furrows are there or ridges are there, wrinkles are there. Then the fractures, to study the way how the plant breaks when subjected to a sufficient pressure. So if there is any furrow or if there is any crack, and if it is a natural crack, then when you are pressing it, the some juice will release from it, or that cell will to that cell growth वहाँ पे आपको मिलेगी थोड़ी सी. But if it is a artificial, तो वो पूरा का पूरा टूट जाएगा. So that we have to note down. Then flowers and leaves, if you are the botanical knowledge यहाँ पे आपको use करना पड़ेगा कि whether that leaves is of Thuja or not properly, whether it is a Ficus indicus or Ficus religius, roots उसके किसके हैं. So for that we have to use our botanical knowledge. Flowers may be same thing, whether it is a Bryonia के flowers है या Belladonna के flowers है या Nux moschata के flowers है या Pulsatilla के flowers है. So for that we have to use our botanical knowledge. Then aroma, so that is the odor. So some parts of the plant may have odor, so that odor should be properly noted. If you want to test it, then you can test whether it is acidic, whether it is a salty, or it is a sweet, or alkaline in test, or the pungent in test. So the test also we can do if it is not harmful. Color, the color is again, the terms are the standardized according to the recommendation of our Bureau of the Standardization. So the color may vary according to the product or according to the place, according to the many external factors. The second one is the microscopic evaluation. So this microscopic examination of the drug we are doing since 1847. This microscopic evaluation will help us to find out the adulterants if it is present in the powdered plant or in the animal drugs, and it is also helpful to identify the purity of that powder drug. Detailed histology of the microscopic appearance of the drug in sectional view and powder form has been given in the monograph of the drug in the pharmacopoeia. So in the plant, what we are doing in the microscopic study, so we are doing the histology. You know the histology from the anatomy. So we are studying the characteristics of that tissues. We are taking the transverse or the longitudinal sections. We are doing the staining of it, and then we are mounting that slab on the microscope. In the powder drugs, जैसे हमको अगर अर्जुन बार्क की पाउडर आई है, so by the smell you can identify कि this is the अर्जुन बार्क, but that may be adulterated by the some other clay, या फिर जो अपनी ईटे रहती है ना उसका भी पाउडर उसमें मिक्स हो सकता है, bricks powder. So that is of same color. So we have to identify that कि whether that powder is of अर्जुना बार की powder है या उसमें brick की powder add की हुई है. So this powder drug is very dangerous to accept अगर ये examination नहीं किया तो. So powder drugs gives a very few microscopical feature for identification. Since the complete structure is not available in the powder drug, लेकिन वो powder अगर है and if the उसका जो coarseness है, if it is बहुत कम है, 40 number से भी कम है, so we should not accept it. Because nothing remain there, ना cell उसमें रहेंगे ना tissues उसमें रहेंगे. The cell content जो है जैसे starch है, gum है, resins है, so they will not be identified properly. So there are no evidence of the source. Proper mounting and reagent can demonstrate the cell wall, blast fiber, or the leaf epidermal tissue. The study of stomatal index also helps to determine the identification of that plant. लेकिन वो पाउडर पूरी टेलकम पाउडर जैसे है, सो इट इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू आइडेंटिफाई द डिफरेंट स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द सेल और द टिश्यूज. देन द थर्ड, देन उसमें ही एक आता है माइक्रोकेमिस्ट्री. इट कंप्राइजेस द स्टडी ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट ऑफ द ड्रग बाय एप्लीकेशन ऑफ केमिकल मेथड्स टू स्मॉल क्वांटिटीज, अ फ्यू mg ऑफ पाउडर ड्रग और हिस्टोलॉजिकल सेक्शन ऑफ अ ड्रग. By these method, various constituents of the drug can be isolated and can be identified. Then the technique, how we are doing this. So for the identification or the isolation of that constituent, usko pehle hum log kya karenge? We will do the certain lab methods on it. Suppose a small quantity of that drug is available to you, then you have to take some drug substance, evaporate it, heat it and evaporate it. The vapors which are collected in the crystallized form do the condensation. यानी आपको जो सब्लिमेशन का जो अरेंजमेंट है वो आपको करना है. बर्नर, पेट्री डिश, स्टैंड, टेक सम ड्रग सब्सटेंस इन इट, हीट इट एट द लो टेम्परेचर, सो द वेपर्स विल फॉर्म, कलेक्ट दैट वेपर्स एंड उसमें हम करेंगे सब्लिमेशन एंड डू द कंडेंसेशन. व्हेन दीज क्रिस्टल्स आर फॉर्म, दे रिप्रेजेंट अ कैरेक्टरिस्टिक पैटर्न ऑफ द प्योर कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट. The crystallography will determine the certain cells or the tissues of that particular part. Then the chemical solvents we are also using, such as for the extraction of the certain constituents from that drug, or we can do the microcrystallization, we can do the microfiltration. So these are the lab methods we are using if that drug substance is in a powder form or if it is not recognized or not be identified by us. So by doing this microchemistry, we can identify. Then for the identification of constituents, we can confirm the melting point, we can do the crystallography, we can do the certain color confirmation test. For example, if it is an alkaloid, then we can use the iodine in potassium iodide, and if the color is brown PPT, that means it contains certain alkaloid. So these are the certain color reaction tests are also available for the standardization. Then the third one is the physical evaluation. So in the physical evaluation, we are doing chromatographic technique, we are doing the UV rays technique or the fluorescence technique. The alkaloid can be passed through the ultraviolet rays and the colors are identified. Jaisa aconite, agar aap UV rays ke niche loge, so you will get the light blue color. Ya berberine agar hai, so you will get the yellow color. The application of physical constituent is largely employed to the active principle of the drug. For example, alkaloids and fixed oils. So the general methods which we are using in this physical evaluation are the solubility or the specific gravity or the melting point or the refractive index, water content. So these physical tests we are doing in the physical evaluation. The next one is the chemical evaluation. So it name suggests we are doing the certain chemical procedures in that chemical evaluation. The chemical methods of evaluation cover the isolation, identification, purification, and characteristic determination of non-cellular drugs of animal origin and drugs of plant having active principles. Chemical assay is done to assess the potency of vegetable and animal source materials in terms of active principles. The chemical assay or the chemical test that we are doing are the color reaction test, or it may be the Mohlish test, it may be the acid value test, it may be the iodine test, it may be the saponification test or the ash value. So this test will determine to identify the drug substance, and also if the some adulterants are present, we can find out with the help of this chemical evaluation. Then the last one is the biological evaluation. So pharmacological activity of certain drugs has been applied to evaluate and standardize them. The assay on living animals and their intact or cut-off organ can indicate the strength of the drug or their preparation. As living organisms are used These tests are known as biological evaluation or biological assay. Using biological evaluation, we can evaluate or standardize the certain drugs which are of animal origin. So this is useful for the nozores, this is useful for the sarcodes. So these are the certain evaluation methods by which we are doing the standardization. To maintain the stability, to get the purified or a drug, or to get the proper efficacy of that drug substance, this is our aim, and for that we are maintaining the stability. And these five methods we are doing in the standardization. So organoleptic, here we are using all our senses, color, structure, size. We are identifying with our eyes, nose, skin and tongue. Microscopic evaluation, here we are doing the evaluation of the plants and animals with the help of certain chemistry also, microchemistry also we are using here, such as micro sublimation or micro crystallization. So we are observing this slide under the microscope by doing the certain lab procedure. Sublimation kar liya, crystallization kar liya, filtration kar liya, and then again observe it under the microscope. So plant ka bhi kar sakte ho and animal ka bhi kar sakte ho. In the plant, if the powder drug substance is available, then it is very difficult to identify the cell structure. So the size, if it is less than 40 number, then it is better way to reject it, because we cannot identify all the cells are broken there, and hence the microscopic evaluation is difficult. Then the third one is the some color test also we are doing in the microscopic evaluation. So certain standard colors are provided by the bureau, so you can match that colors of the alkaloid of that given sample. The third one is the physical evaluation. In the physical evaluation, we are doing the certain lab techniques such as fluorescent test or the chromatography or the observation under ultraviolet rays. So again, the standard colors are given that only you have to match. The fourth one is the chemical evaluation. Here we are doing the certain chemical assay to identify and the drug substance and also the adulterants in it. And the last one is the biological evaluation, which is doing for the drug material which is available from the animal, whether it is an intact part or it may be from the broken part. So we have to evaluate it with the help of microscope by doing the certain studies. So nozodes and sarcodes are also under this group. So here are the mother solutions or the potencies. Certain standards are given on the basis of which you can standardize these things. So center is in the Ghaziabad. So they refuse, and standard have been worked out in the homeopathic pharmacopoeia laboratory. So what they are doing, they are making the standardization, and if the that drug is not standardized, if it is not that only one, it can be diffused. So they are doing the systemic analysis, and they are doing the determination of constituents, and they are doing the analysis of the drug. So in the analysis, what they are saying, they are seeing that any foreign organic matter is present here or not. So that is, they are doing the analysis of vegetables and the plant drugs. Then the foreign inorganic matter is present here or not. So they are also using the certain chemicals, and they are find out the inorganic matter. With that, they are also seeing the moisture content of that drug substance. Then they are doing the systemic analysis also. That is the organoleptic examination, histological examination, then determination of the acid insoluble ash, or determination of ash, determination of the moisture content. And lastly, they will determine the constituents of the given sample. So if it is a belladonna or calendula or Evina sativa, so they will do the analysis, that is a systemic analysis of all these constituents. Then they will determine the constituents, the quality of standard, which is depend upon the amount of constituent present in that drug capable of being extracted, have been prescribed for certain drugs. So har ek drug ke constituents jo hai, which are present in that, it is also stand, it is also unka standard formula hai usme. They are extracted in continuous apparatus and extract thus obtained are determined by weight by removing the solvents. By using the commonly used solvents are the strong alcohol or the dilute alcohol or maybe the benzene or it may be the water. Then they will find out the alkaloids. The alkaloids are recovered from the drug sample by extraction, then purification, etc. So they are doing the standardization of the mother tincture. They are doing the they will check the standardization of the mother solutions and of course the attenuation. So suppose it is a इथुजा अगर लिया है, सो इथुजा के लिए द मदर टिंचर अगर आपके पास आया है एंड इफ इट इज ऑफ द ओल्ड मेथड का अगर उसमें है, सो द स्पेसिफिक ग्रेविटी दे विल चेक फर्स्ट, देन दे विल सी द अल्कोहल कंटेंट इन दैट मदर टिंचर. सो दे आर हैविंग अ स्टैंडर्ड वैल्यूज. सो इफ द मदर टिंचर, फॉर एग्जाम्पल द अल्कोहल कंटेंट इन दैट इथुजा साइनोपियम, it should be 52% to 62%. This is a standard value. They are having the charts. But if it is more than 80%, they will reject that mother tincture. Then the pH of that ethuja, it should be in between 5.3 to 6.2. If it is less or if it is more, again they will reject it. Then they will identify that the whether it is ethuja synovium or it is at something else. So for that, they will do the analysis. So the preparation of solution they will do. So they will prepare one solution by shake the 2 ml with 5 ml of chloroform. Allow the layers to separate. Evaporate the chloroform layer in a dish to dryness on a water bath. Dissolve the residue in water by little warming. The solution S is discolored when a few drops of potassium permanganate solution is added. To the solution S, add a drop of alcoholic FeCl3 solution. So this will produce yellowish green color. So if all these things are proper, then this is identified that okay, this is the ethuja. After that, they can do the thin layer chromatography. So in this way, they are doing the chemical analysis and the physical analysis of any mother tincture or the any potency. Then they are doing the standardization of the vehicles also. Such as sugar of milk. So for the identification of the sugar of milk, we know the purity test we have checked. So if you identify the sugar of milk, what we have to do, we can heat it, we can melt it, we can burn it, and when you burn, you will get the smell of that burning sugar, and the carbon will be remain behind. So this identify that this is a sugar of milk. When you heat it with the potassium cuprate tartrate solution, the copious precipitate of cuprous oxide will form. Then you can check the acidity and the alkalinity of that sugar of milk. So for that, you have to take the 5 gram of sugar of milk, dissolve it in a 50 ml of freshly boiled water, requires for neutralization not more than 0.5 ml of NaOH phenolphthalein solution, which can be used as an indicator. So this will differentiate ki this is acidic or this is a basic. Then you can do the different purity test that we have done in the lab, so that we can identify the adulterants if it is present in the sugar of milk. Similarly, we can do the purity test of alcohol also, that is the iodoform test that we have seen. Then we can also do the refractive index, aldehyde test, ketone test, fusel oil test that we have done in the laboratory. Other tests also we can do. Similarly, we can do the purity test of glycerin, alcohol, almond oil. So any vehicle, we can do HPL are doing the purity test and check that adulterants were present or not. So the different books are also available for the standardization. The standardization of homeopathic drug 1, 2 and the 3 volumes are available for the standardization. Then the volume 1 contains the pharmaceutical the pharmacognostical, physiochemical and pharmacological profiles of the 11 drugs. So these are the drugs ki uska standardization ye volume 1 mein present hai. Then the volume 2, it contains the 12 drugs where the again the pharmacognostical, physicochemical and pharmacological profile is present in the 12 drugs. And in the volume 3, again the 11 drugs are there. There are the certain centers also standardization. Two types ke hai. The first category is a true standardization. A definite phytochemical or the group of constituent is known to have activity. These products are highly concentrated and no longer represent a whole herb and are not considered as a pharmaceutical. In many cases, they are vastly more effective than the whole herb. So, and the second one is the other type of standardization is based on the manufacturer guarantee. The presence of certain percentage of marker compounds, these are not indicator of therapeutic activity or the quality of the herb. So in this way, they are doing the two types of standardization. So the true standardization, they are doing the different tests for the standardization, and the other type of standardization that is based upon the guarantee of that manufacturer. So these are the two types of standardization. Then in the legislations or there are the certain drug and cosmetic act, maybe the standardizations are important. The certain rules are there for that standardization. So this is about the brief standardization of the drug substances. So this completes the chapter. If you have any difficulty, then you can ask anytime.